episode 13 of Veilstone City Gym, or of Veilstone City, and today we're going to the Veilstone City Gym. As you can see, this is nighttime, so I recorded this last night and not today, because it's in the morning right now, and I'm on spring break. So Dawn comes out, she's like, oh my god, and there's Crasher Wake, I'm like, holy shit, he's freaking fat. And yeah, he goes away. I think he's a gym leader. He was supposed to be like the third gym or something, I don't remember. So I go in, he's like, this is all fighting type Pokemon, so you can use psychic or flying type, and I'm like, dude, I know that. So here, the point is to push the bags, which is kind of annoying, because I keep pushing the bags, like, running into them, and hit the tire, so you can advance the next person. So this guy, he said he's a karate quad, so I'm thinking there's four of these guys, so T-Punch would do a lot, and I forgot to heal, which is kind of bad. I wasn't sure if I can one-hit KO all of these guys, so to make sure, I just T-Bolt, because it has more base power, plus the stab. And yeah, Machoke comes out, our T-Punch. This is quite good damage, and I get like 800 EXP, which is good, so I'm done healing. Now I'm back, and after you go out of the gym, you have to do all the frickin' puzzles again, so, yeah, the puzzles give me kinda hard time. I don't know what to do, so I just push up the beanbag, and, you push that beanbag all the way up, hits that tire, and you verse the second quad person. And the third guy's over there, like, right when you go down those stairs. So this guy has three Machops, one Machoke, so I T-Punch. And Livefire is gonna be level 45 soon, which is good, man. I mean, it's good. Oh, he has a Metatite, and I level 45 off of that, which is good. And he has a Machoke. I knew he had a Machoke, so I used Return. Wanted to see if it'd KO, but it didn't. And he uses Foresight. So yeah, I just Return again because I don't want to waste PP. And Livar is evolving, so I gotta press BBBB. And I verse a third member. Right there, yeah. So, this guy has a Krogunk. So I just T-Punch, kills it. I skipped the battle scene, so this would be faster. T-Punch the Machoke, KOs. So now I gotta go around, I think. I gotta go around because the guy's blocking my way. So right now I pause it because, like, I know this puzzle's gonna take forever for me to do, so. How come I didn't pause it yet? I thought I paused it. Okay, so, god damn it. How come I didn't pause it yet? I know I paused it. Alright, so I'm just gonna talk about Livewire right now. I'm gonna, oh wait, there's a karate guy. Okay, so this karate guy. He has Heracross, which doesn't get one-hit KO'd by T-Bolt, which was really, really weird. And the Aerial Aces, and I return for the KO. So yeah, Livewire. I'm planning on teaching him from the move tutor, giving him Ice Punch, just for the coverage, and I'm going to give him Brick Break too, so his moveset is going to be Return, Thunder Punch, Ice Punch, and Brick Break. It's gonna be a physical one. It might be bad for me. Just, alright guys, should I get T-Bolt or Thunder Punch? Which one should I leave? I'll show you guys the stats in the next video. So I verse Maylene, and she does like a Super Saiyan intro. She goes like, ah, Super Saiyan. And she has a Metatite, and I T-Bolt, and a KOs. Oh my god, there's a garbage truck here now. Oh shit. Okay, so it sends in Lucario, and it's level 32. I T-Punch, and it does not KO. She uses Drain Punch. She doesn't get much HP back. Doesn't do much to me either. And I get 1.4k EXP from it. And her last Pokemon's a Machoke. I mean, she should have sent out her Machoke first instead of her Lucario. I mean, WTF. So you get Rock Tomb, and she gets the Speed Attacks. And I T-Bolt for the KO. So guys, yeah. I beat the fourth gym leader. I don't know who the fifth gym leader is, I forgot. So I get a cool cobble badge. And now I can use fly, so in the next episode I'm gonna go to the Galactic Tower and get fly. And I just talk to those things. Guys, thanks for watching.